Hi students, welcome. Now we are discussing about how to draw the projection of given solids. So the solid is nothing but it is a three-dimensional object, length, breadth and height, and also it is a three-directional, x direction, y direction and z direction. Clear? So today our problem is a hexagonal prism of base side 30 mm and axis length 70 mm. Resting on one of its base edges on HP with axis inclined 30 degree to HP and parallel to VP. Draw its projection. Clear? So our component is hexagonal prism. In that hexagonal prism, first of all you draw one XY reference. Clear? So the hexagon, how to draw the hexagon? We know that two different, one is for even that hexagon is this directional or otherwise equally inclined this one. So either first case or otherwise second case, both are hexagon only. But as per our problem, a hexagonal prism of base side 30 mm and axis length 70 mm is resting on one of its base edge on HP while it's inclined to HP. So when the solid is inclined, at the time only one base edges is resting. Therefore, while this selection of this hexagon, while tilting, only base corner is resting on HP. While selecting the number 2, the base edge is resting on HP. Therefore, our problem is number 2 is correct one. So therefore, first you draw hexagon as per that given size is 30 mm side. So this is hexagon. Clear? So now it is solid, compulsory axis must. So how to determine that axis means we join the diagonals at least 2. So even you put 3 also, no problem. So this is the center. Clear? So after that you draw the projection from top view to front view. Why we are selecting first top view? That is below XY. We know that the solid is tilt as per the problem. Therefore, before tilting, that's one of its base of its solid is completely resting on HP. Therefore, the true shape of the prism, it is nothing but hexagon, is visible only on top view. Clear? Therefore, first you draw the top view. Then you draw the projection line. Finally, you complete front view. Clear? So it is prism and axis is 70 mm long. So the base is resting on HP. Therefore, it starts here. So 70 mm. So this one is, let us consider this is 70 mm. Clear? So while seeing that front view, this edge and that edge. So three edges are visible, therefore you draw three edges. Clear? Right. This is the initial case before tilting. So we assign that letters means, so for example, top 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, the top surface 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash, 4 dash, 2 dash, 5 dash, 1 dash, 6 dash. Clear? Next, the base A, B, C, D, E and F. Therefore, in front view, A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, B dash, E dash, A dash, F dash. So, this is the solid before tilting. Clear? Now the solid is inclined. At the time of inclination, one of its base edge, so we are considering the ABCDEFA. This is the base edges. Therefore, while tilting, the base edge C to D, that one only is lies. Clear? So at the angle 30 degree, the axis inclined 30 degree. So first you draw 30 degree line. Clear? You draw 30 degree line. That is axis. This is the axis is 30 degree line. while tilting that component, the base edges, so you know that the axis here also the axis is present, but it's coincide with visible edge 2B, clear. So now the axis and base is right angle, therefore the axis and base is right angle. Axis is 30 degree means definitely base is 60 degree default. So here the B to C, how much distance is the same distance here to here, this one. So B to C, A to B, A to B, B to C. So while it is actually it is C dash comma D dash, no. So the C D, the base edge is resting as per our problem, clear. Then you draw the same. Same 17, clear, this one. So this one is 90 degree as it is, clear. So the 2B edge is visible, so therefore here to here the dark line 2B, here axis is there, same letters A dash comma F dash, B dash comma E dash, C dash comma D dash. Similarly, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash comma 4 dash, 5 dash, 6 dash. Then you draw the projection lines, clear, from each and every one. So here to here, 2, 5, 1, 6, C, D, BE and AF. This is the projection line. Similarly, from first diagram into fourth diagram projection line. So this is phi comma E. You draw the projection lines phi E. Next, this is 6F 4D. 4 in 1 projection line. Clear. Next, this one is 1A 3C. This is also 4 in 1 projection line. Next, this one is 2B, 2 in 1 projection line, clear. So from here to here projection line, similar case from here to here projection line, because we know that this is the first diagram, this one is second diagram, second and third both are same shape and size, finally we get fourth one. So locate the points. So A versus A, this is A, B and B, C and C, D and D, E, F, clear. A point versus A point, B projection versus B projection. So therefore, it is top view without dash A, B, C, D, E, F. Similarly, top surface, hexagon surface, so 1 versus 1, 1. This is 2 and 2, 3 and 3, 4, 5, 6, clear. So number 1 projection, here number 1 projection, 1 versus 1. So finally, while seeing in top view the component, the top hexagon surface is completely visible. Therefore, here this is 1, 2, 3, 4 is the top surface of the hexagon prism. Clear, this is top surface completely visible. Here the bottom 50%, that is in that portion, in the top view, the left half of the hexagonal surface is visible and right half of the hexagonal surface is invisible, clear. Therefore, this is left half visible, this right half B to C invisible, C to D invisible and D to E invisible. So the invisible edges we mentioned hidden line, because that also object line but invisible object line. And then so A1, B2, E5, F6, the four edges are visible. A1, B2, F6 and E5, these edges are visible. Here the bottommost, while top view, the bottommost C to 3, D to 4 is invisible, but the object is there, but it's invisible. So C to 3, from here to here invisible, but already the A1 visible edges are overlapping. So the balance, the place only dimension hidden line. That means actually C2 3, but A1 is dark line, therefore the gap between 1 to 3 only hidden line. Similar case D4 invisible, D2 4 invisible, but already up to 6 visible line, therefore in gap between 6 to 4 invisible hidden line. Clear? So this is the solution as per our problem. A hexagonal prism while tilting inclined to HP, one of its base edge here CD, the base edge is resting on HP, and axis sits parallel to VP. So for example, the here top O1 center, here O2 center, therefore O1 to O2 as the center. Similar case O1 O2, we draw the projection line here and here, means this is O1 center, this is O2 center. If we need, you draw the axis. Clear? Here the axis is 30 degree inclined HP and axis is parallel to VP. Clear? Right. So we mention the dimensions as per the standard format. Clear? Thank you.